My name is Paul Ridker. I'm a cardiologist at Boston's Brigham and Women's Hospital, where I direct the Center for Cardiovascular Disease Prevention. And I have the honor of serving as a Eugene Brownwell Professor of Medicine at the Harvard Medical School, also in Boston, Massachusetts. So the RESCUE trial was designed to see whether or not a novel interleukin-6 monoclonal antibody called Ziltivekimab could be effective in potentially lowering cardiovascular biomarkers in very high-risk patients with chronic kidney disease. You might ask, why are we doing that? Well, we've learned that inflammation is crucial to atherosclerosis, and our 2017 10,000-patient CANTOS trial with an interleukin-1 beta inhibitor proved that reducing inflammation can be just as effective as reducing cholesterol and preventing cardiovascular events. But that drug, as many of your readers are aware, also had large effects on cancer and is now being developed as a drug for oncology. So we're looking for novel anti-inflammatory drugs that we think can have similar benefits, and the interleukin-6 pathway, for reasons that are both genetic, clinical, and experimental, seems to be a central target for atherosclerosis. So RESCUE was a 264-patient phase 2 24-week trial of multiple different doses of ziltivekimab, primarily to see whether it would lower CRP, C-reactive protein, the biomarker of inflammation, and also to see what it might do for other biomarkers and for safety. And the bottom line of the trial was it was very effective. 85 to 90% reductions in CRP, large reductions in fibrinogen, serum amyloid A, which is another pentraxin, large reductions in secretory phospholipase A2, very interesting reductions in lipoprotein little a. That's biologically relevant. As we all understand, lowering LP little a is also likely to have relevance for this disease. And then on the safety side, very exciting data that this particular drug had no adverse effects on atherogenic lipids. So the ApoB to ApoA ratio, the total cholesterol, the HDL cholesterol ratio were unchanged with therapy. That's important because several IL-6 monoclonal antibodies that are available for other uses, such as rheumatoid arthritis, have adverse cholesterol effects. And at least in this short-term 24-week trial, we saw no real adverse effects on liver function and no real adverse effects on bone marrow function. So there was no grade 2 or 3 thrombocytopenia or neutropenia. All of that's very good news. And it basically says this agent looks like it might be worth advancing into a major cardiovascular outcomes trial to try to define whether or not we can actually lower cardiovascular event rates. Sure. So RESCUE was purposely done among patients with very high risk for atherosclerotic disease, defined by having chronic kidney disease, moderate to severe, grade 3 or 4 chronic kidney disease, and an elevated high sensitivity CRP greater than or equal to 2 mg/L. That's a very high risk group for atherosclerotic events in which the inflammatory process is particularly relevant, perhaps even more so than the cholesterol part of the process. There's some very interesting reasons for why inflammation is so important in that setting. And from an anti-inflammatory perspective, it's a population of patients where we probably would not want to give colchicine, which is another proven anti-inflammatory drug, because colchicine is excreted by the kidney. The primary endpoints were change in CRP and change in the other biomarkers, as I laid out for you. And again, all the results were quite positive and the safety was very good. So the key findings, again, were 85 to 90% reductions in the inflammatory cascade, that is reductions in CRP itself, and concomitant large reductions in fibrinogen, serum amyloid A, SPLA2, LP little a, as well as neutral effects on the cholesterol biomarkers, and again, neutral effects on the safety biomarkers. So if one looks at this in total, one has clear evidence that we have a potential novel therapeutic that can be advanced into a large-scale cardiovascular outcomes trial, which we're very excited to be starting very soon. Well, the fundamental conclusion from the trial is that the potential for IL-6 inhibition, as previously proven for interleukin-1 inhibition, is substantial. So on the basis of these new data, the sponsor of this particular trial, Novo Nordisk, has gone ahead and initiated a large-scale cardiovascular outcomes trial, which has the name Zeus, the Ziltivekimab Cardiovascular Outcome Study, which will ultimately enroll 6,200 patients across the world who will have the same enrollment criterion: known atherosclerotic disease, stage 3 or 4 chronic kidney disease, and elevated CRP. Again, a very high risk group for cardiovascular events. And they'll be randomized to 15 milligrams of ziltivekimab given subcutaneously once every month or to placebo, everybody getting very aggressive standard of care, including high-dose statin therapy. And the primary outcome of that trial will no longer be surrogate biomarkers as it was in RESCUE. It'll be hard cardiovascular event rates, so myocardial infarction, stroke, cardiovascular death. And it's probably quite interesting to your viewers that the same pathway of innate immune function that goes from the NLRP3 inflammasome to IL-1 to IL-6 and ultimately producing CRP is also involved in the progression of kidney disease. So a secondary endpoint of the trial is a progression of renal failure itself. So this trial is very interesting, focusing on a group of patients with high unmet need, and we'll be tracking both progression of kidney disease as well as progression of atherosclerotic disease. And in fact, my co-chair of the trial, Dr. Vlado Perkovic, is a nephrologist. So it makes sense because I'm a cardiologist and the two of us have been working with a sponsor to develop this trial. And I'm very pleased to say that we'll have investigator meetings starting in June and actual enrollment in the trial globally starting in September. And it's a very exciting time for novel drug development in atherosclerosis. I think the take-home message from RESCUE is that cardiologists are learning that inflammation biology is here to stay. CANTOS with an IL-1 beta inhibitor, COLCOT and LODOCO2 with colchicine. We now have three major cardiovascular outcome trials telling us that what we call residual inflammatory risk is very important. So measuring inflammation in our patients is crucial, and matching a therapeutic intervention beyond only focusing on LDL cholesterol, we now know is the future of atherosclerotic disease. RESCUE is a stepping stone on the way to a whole series of novel therapies for this purpose. The RESCUE phase 2 data allow us to launch this new large-scale trial called Zeus, which will directly test whether another novel anti-inflammatory, in this case, ziltivekimab, an IL-6 ligand inhibitor, can also reduce cardiovascular event rates. And ultimately, I would predict 10 years from now, I believe all atherosclerosis patients will be receiving very aggressive cholesterol-lowering therapies and very aggressive anti-inflammatory therapies. This new trial, Zeus, is a major step in that direction, focusing on a very high-risk population. But I think down the road, what we're learning is that we have huge opportunities to reduce inflammation to the benefit of our patients, which is going to go beyond what we can currently do by lowering LDL cholesterol. So it's a very, very exciting time from a biologic perspective, and I would predict a very fulfilling time from a clinical perspective.